So hi everyone, today I wanted to show you this excavator, and it is inspired by the set 8043, which was released 15 years ago. And that set used four medium power functions medium motors to control six functions. And I did the same here, but using BuWizz 2.0 and BuWizz Micro Motors. So in total, this set has four motors and it's controlling six functions. So how do I do that? Basically, one of the four motors is switching the functions of the other three motors, so it can control the three functions underneath, which are rotating of the superstructure, one track, and the other track. So those are three functions on the bottom. And then I'm using the fourth motor to switch. As you've seen, this handle moves. And now the three motors are powering the rotation of the bucket, secondary boom lift, and of course the primary boom lift. It has quite a good range of movement, as you can see. And instead of the big actuators that the original set used, I'm using small linear actuators, four of them, two to power the main boom lift, and then one for the secondary boom lift, and finally one more for the rotation of the shovel. And now I'm gonna switch the lower, and now we can rotate, we can move, we can also rotate and move at the same time. And because there are no wires going through the superstructure, this thing can rotate indefinitely, so there is no limit on how much it can spin. In total, I used around 986 parts, so which is quite a lot of parts for its size, because I put a lot of attention into details. So we have a full cap, everything is nice and paneled, there are almost no gaps, there's even an exhaust here. So all in all, it's a very dense but still robust build, and I'm really happy how it turned out. And of course there will be also be footage of the model actually in the pit picking up the Lego bricks and putting them into the dump truck. So one more thing worth mentioning is how do I charge the model. Basically, I can remove the rear grill like this, and now we have full access to the BuWizz 2.0, to the charging port, and of course the button. And if I remove the rear bumper, you can also see the BuWizz motors driving the model. So the one on the top switches the functions of the other three. So the most right one is powering the turntable and the shovel. The middle one is powering the right track and the secondary boom lift. And the leftmost is powering the left track and the main boom lift. And as you can see, it's a very compact design. And I can also remove one of the sides here. It's not much visible, but you can still see the switching mechanism here. So basically, you can see the gears. There are a lot of gears in this model. And this is the mechanism that switches between the functions. So yeah, it's a very compact, very sturdy model, and I really like that we only need one BuWizz to power the whole thing, all six functions. Just like the original, the tracks can be powered independently because there are two functions passing through the turntable. So the turntable, which can also spin of course, is also carrying two functions. So the central gear here, which is powering this side, and then there is another gear ring around that central axle that is powering this side of the track. So it is very compact, full of gears, and I'm just happy I managed to squeeze everything inside. If you like the way it turned out, and if this brings you memories of the old sets from 15 years ago, then please like and subscribe. Thank you.